understand you'd like me to hear your confession?
Yes, I would. Not exactly a confession. I haven't yet done the deed.
I'm here for you, Mark.
Is it possible for me to know a woman in the biblical sense?
Are we talking about sexual intercourse?
I think so.
Outside marriage?
My penis speaks to me, Father Brendan. This therapist suggested I could work with a sex surrogate who would be sensitive to my unusual needs.
In my heart, I feel like he'll give you a free pass on this one. Go for it.
Hey folks, it's Jim from the Movie Wine here to review the film The Sessions, based on the true story of Mark O'Brien. Mark, played by John Hawks, is a poet paralyzed from the neck down due to polio, determined to lose his virginity. With the blessings of his local priest, Father Brendan, played by William H. Macy, Mark is given the go-ahead to contact a sex therapist named Cheryl Green, played by Helen Hunt, in order to fulfill his dreams. Depending on your way of thinking, a role where your body from the neck down is paralyzed could be really constraining or really freeing, since you don't have to worry about using your body as any form of language. Regardless, Hawks gives a terrific performance that rewards sympathy without trying too hard. Despite his misfortune, he's deeply religious, yet never resentful, comforted in the idea that there is someone to blame, such as God, who he believes has a wicked sense of humor. Mark's own sense of humor makes him easy to root for. The rest of the supporting cast is just as good, though I'm undecided on how I feel about the second half, where Hunt as Cheryl starts to develop feelings for Mark as her marriage is struggling. The actress, even unclothed, is never glamorized for the camera. It's right on the line between a flattering and an unflattering performance. Also, Moonblood Good, whose looks have been downplayed for the role, plays Mark's assistant Vera, while Adam Arkin plays Josh, Cheryl's jealous husband. Father Brendan might not be the most authentic priest in his open-minded attitude, but Macy brings a lot of humor, which is no surprise. It's refreshing to see a priest that isn't naive or oblivious to sex and doesn't treat it as a taboo subject. In fact, that's one of the film's greatest strengths, its honesty. These characters are not treated like morons. They talk about sex in a nonchalant but realistic way. Despite falling a victim of polio, some might be surprised by how life-affirming this film is and how positive it is in its outlook on sex, as Mark is open both emotionally and physically, which are interconnected. The story might be a little thin, but The Sessions is a solid feel-good flick with superb performances and sharp writing. That's it from the Movie Rewind. Have a good day, folks. Until next time.